I'm Anna, your virtual guide to Sonarworks software. In this tutorial, we'll show you how to export a SoundID Reference speaker calibration profile for the Audient ORIA integration and how to import it in the Audient ORIA app. Note that your speakers will have to be remeasured as the new export feature will be using the Audient ORIA hardware and software during the process. First, open both Audient ORIA and the SoundID Reference Measure applications. Click on Get Started and select your speaker configuration. We will be using a 9.1.6 speaker setup. Go through the setup checklist to ensure everything is ready for the measurement process. Next, select Audient ORIA as your audio interface. A notification will appear in the ORIA app. Click OK to confirm you're entering measurement mode. If you encounter the measurement mode not detected message or any other ORIA-specific warnings at this stage, search for the warning title in the SoundID Reference Help Center. We can now proceed as normal with the rest of the measurement stages, as there are no additional steps required for Audient ORIA specifically. Should you encounter any device-specific issues during the measurement process, visit the troubleshooting guide linked in the description. During the results overview, we can see the measured frequency response, level difference, and delay values for each channel individually. Click on Save and Finish to name your Sonarworks calibration profile and save it to the default Sonarworks projects directory. Proceed with opening the SoundID Reference standalone app to load and export the profile. With the SoundID Reference app open, we can close the Measure app as it's no longer needed. Click on Add New Output. Our device in use is the Audient ORIA. Click on the Select Your Calibration Profile dropdown and select your calibration profile for recent items, or click on Open an existing profile to load the file from the Sonarworks Projects folder. Before proceeding to the export stage, we can adjust our preset DSP settings, such as listening spot, limit controls, dry wet, and more. We can also select our target mode and apply the Dolby custom target or the translation check mode. If you're going through the process for the first time, we recommend keeping the default settings, flat target, and all the DSP features enabled as is. Keep in mind that you can import several presets to Audient ORIA and switch between them in the preset panel in the ORIA app. In the output panel on the left, click on the Export Preset to Device button to start the export process. Next, select Audient ORIA from the integrations list. To proceed, we recommend using the Direct Transfer to Audient ORIA application export option. The profile will be transferred to the ORIA app, and you will be able to create a new preset or rewrite an existing one. Alternatively, a parametric file can be created. The second export option will create a bin file that can be uploaded to Audient ORIA manually at any given time. As we proceed with the direct transfer option, a confirmation message will appear in the ORIA app. For this demonstration, we will overwrite the existing preset and replace it with our new calibration profile. If you run into any issues with device connectivity at this stage, such as unable to reach Audient ORIA or other warnings, search for the error title in the SoundID Reference Help Center as mentioned earlier. It can take up to 2 minutes to export the calibration preset. Once done, the SoundID Reference app will automatically disable the calibration. With the calibration running directly in Audient ORIA, we can also disable the Launch on Startup setting in the app, as the SoundID Reference software is no longer needed. You will likely return to it only to export more profiles. And the app can be closed to disable double calibration taking place. To view the applied EQ curve to each channel, we can click on the setup in the Audient ORIA app and select one of the channels to preview the EQ curve, trim, delay, and crossover values. Enjoy the results and subscribe to our channel for more support videos. Thanks for watching.